1, 2, 3. 1, 2, 3. 1, 2, 3. 1, 2, 3. Okay, Manitos, we're back. We're in chamber 6. Is there a way? Yeah, okay, right at the top. So we're back in chamber 6. I cleared the enemies out. It's numbered kind of numerically. The entrance is, the best entrance, I think, is through there, which leads to chamber 5. So if you come out there, don't worry. Now that you have high jump, this isn't a problem anymore. It should be much easier to navigate Monstro with high jump. But in this chamber, we have a couple chests I didn't get. One of which has a torn page, which is going to be important in a bit. I don't know if I can get that yet. I think I need the other ability. I'll try one more time, but I don't think I can get that. Nope, probably can if I try hard enough, but I'm not really that crazy about it. So just want to show that real quick, because I know some people are probably going to ask about that. So this is not going to be... this is going to be a bit of a catch-up part, because I've left a couple of side quests undone, and this part is to alleviate that. So this should lead right back out to Chamber 1. Yep. So if you're good enough, you can... Actually, let me just do it this way. So this is the very entrance. This is the entrance. Go straight. You'll go into Chamber 3. Maybe I was wrong. Okay, so here. Chamber 3. Jump up here. Go right through here. Chamber 6. Super easy to get in there. Yeah, so that's definitely... This is the way to get in. Then you'll be there. Just gonna jump back up there. Easy peasy. There are a couple chests I haven't gotten in here. And it's kind of annoying, but... fuck it. I'll leave them for later. I took like 20 minutes, and I went quickly to Wonderland and Traversetown, and... killed a couple, like, of the, like, little mage heartless. The Requiems, the Rhapsodies, whatever they're fucking called. Just to get some, items. If you're gonna farm those, so to get Thunder Shards, Bright Shards, Frost Shards, and Blaze Shards, I recommend doing it now. Because while they don't disappear, a lot of the enemies become tougher in all the worlds and are replaced with tougher heartless. So, like, you can still find them. I think they're some in Wonderland, even at the end of the game. It's much easier now, because they only take one hit or so. So, if you go back to Traversetown, you know, just take a couple shots at them, get a couple items here and there. They're not worth very good XP. It's like 1 or 2 or 3, 4. But this is the best chance to farm them for items, because every enemy has a set amount, like a percentage chance to drop each item. And... that does not change when they level up, so you're going to have the same luck getting them now as you would later in the game, except maybe you might have more Lucky Strike equipped, so like Sora and Donald could have it equipped. I think it's easier just to get them now, because you can quickly take care of them and move on to the next area. I thought I got something. Anyway, I'm going to show the fire arts and stuff in a different part, because... there are 7 spells, and so far we can only get the arts for 6 of them. We need to be able to get the gravity ones, and that's not, or the arrow ones, and that's not for, that's in one of the other worlds. But we will get back to them. I'll do a whole, like, I'll quickly go through and do that. I'll make like a separate video, or no, I'll make the video in here, but I'll make it separate total. So, first things first, if you come over here, you'll notice there's now a house here. And, way to spoil it for me, but it's Geppetto's house. Pinocchio, hey, it's Sora. Well, why hello, Sora. How did you get here? A man named Leon helped us. He even got us this house to live in. I don't know how I'll ever repay his kindness. Say, I hear you three are fighting the Heartless. I thought you might be able to help you, so I made this. Geppetto is a gummy ship. But of course, Pinocchio and I can't thank you enough. We'll do anything we can to help you. So... if you're going for the trophies to unlock all of the gummy ships, there's a couple. You have to... Oh, first of all, Wishing Star. I don't know if that's better. It's 3 wishes. It's got 1 less strength, but it has Finisher Plus, whereas this one is just harder to deflect. I think I'm going to switch to Wishing Star, because powerful finishers are pretty good. I don't like the design of it, but I'll use it. So if you talk to Geppetto after doing certain milestones, I'll look what I've cooked up this time. Sid, there you go. I don't know if you have to exit to talk to him again. Mean good even without Jimmy's help. So you have to, there's a couple of gummy ships that you unlock with Geppetto. They're based on the amount of heartless ships that you've destroyed, or it might be heartless in general. I'm not sure. I know the ships count as heartless though. So if you go in and talk to him again, maybe. But anyway, they're different blueprints. They're mostly cosmetic. Like you'll unlock the Cactar ship. Oh, see it? There it is. You'll unlock the Aerith ship, the Cloud ship. They kind of just were built to look like them. They're not really battle, like they're not great for battle. I think there's one called the Hyperion that's pretty good for battle, but that's about it. So come back in, talk to him a couple times based on the amount of heartless you beat. The other thing is always talk to Pinocchio at least once, because you also unlock the Chocobo ship, by talking to Pinocchio 30 different times. But you can't just talk to him 30 times in a row. You can only talk to him once per time you go into his house. So just be sure to do that as you're trying to talk to Geppetto. So I unlocked everything from him. Honestly, I might not even try to do that because I don't care about getting the ships in this, but that's how to unlock it. Those are two of some of the harder ones. We've also, like I said, I went around getting some of the items just really quick, like 20 minutes. So I should have some of them unlocked. It bothers me that the one on the table in the middle isn't the one I synthesize with. Okay, so now I can make the guard earring because I have enough. I guess bright shards was the one I was missing here. Angel bangle because I have bright gems. Golem chain, more bright shards, and spirit gems. Still need the XP thing. The XP earring, I'm not going to be able to get for a bit because I need power stones. Okay, so I know how to get the power stone. That's actually in this world. Fury stones, I'm not 100. I think Mithril stone is definitely the pot scorpion, which I could go take on again now that I have guard. So anyway, come back here. You've got to have three of each. I could make another power chain. As a general rule, until I've gotten all of the synthesis items, I don't like to make these items twice. Unless I know for a fact I can farm them. Like Bright Shard, Spirit Shard, I can farm these, but I'm not going to. I need Mithril for that. Rune Armlets, I need Frost Gem, Thunder Gem, so I'll get that in the next world. Blazing Stone, I don't remember where to get that. Frost Stone, don't. Actually, I know where to get the Blazing Stone. Frost Stone, I don't. I know where to get that one too, I think. Mithril and Orichalcum. Alright, so we've gotten all the ones we can here. Let's change up the equipment. Let's see. Golem Chain raises strength and defense by like a significant amount. An Angel raises max HP and defense. So this one raises strength, defense, and AP. I think if I do this, it'll unequip one of my things though. The defense goes up, the AP goes down by one, strength goes down by one. I'll do it anyway. And then this one increases magic and summoning power. So I'll keep that for now. Donald, Proterra, let's go with... this one raises strength and defense. Defense goes down by one. I'm not really concerned with his strength, though. Raises max AP and defense. This one could be pretty good for him. I'd rather he has some more AP. Actually, Goofy might even be able to use that more. If it's Horn, raises max HP and defense. Slightly raises max HP and strength. I think, let's see, White Fang would be pretty good for him here. Keeps the strength the same, but his HP goes down a bit. Golem Chain increases even more. I'm going to do that. And then Goofy has more AP abilities though, so slightly raises strength. I think instead I'll do, where was it? Slightly raise. Okay, so that I'm definitely giving to Donald. But let's see. This would be good. I'll give him White Fang. It decreases strength by one, but it's overall more rounded. Raises max HP and defense. Slightly raises max HP and defense. Okay, so give him the magic armlet. HP goes down, defense goes down, but magic goes up, which is important. Let's look at everyone's abilities. I have one AP. Nothing to really equip it on. No, I'll be good. Treasure magnet, sure. Goofy. Give up. Okay, so this is a pretty good skill I recommend everyone keeps. He can give up 1 MP to give 30 HP to the entire party. So that's pretty good. I want to get these two again, but I need more AP for it. Alright, so that's good. Next up, I'll do it if it's in this area, but I'm gonna walk to Merlin's the long way just to see if I can grab some Nocturnes on the way or whatever they're called. They don't have like a shared name. I'm just gonna call them Tiny Wizards. So see if I can fight. Okay, so I'm not going to. You'll know immediately if the enemy spawns here because. Okay, so there's a special enemy here. It's over there. I don't have it equipped, so. For this, I like to put stop on my heart bar. You'll see why in a sec. But if an enemy doesn't spawn right here, then that's how you know they've spawned, because they're a special enemy, so they take up the entire area. What these are you need to defeat six of these. First one, then two, then three. Problem is, they can't spot you. If they see you, you need to kill them before they get a chance to sound the alarm. I might not be able to do it now. I did it once earlier, the first time I saw them. But the best thing I can recommend is you gotta sneak up behind them, actually. So this is good for now. So, see, they got alarmed, but I managed to kill them. Now two will spawn here. Only one saw me. Gotta hit it quick. And there's gonna be three more. Stop is kind of useless by itself. I recommend waiting for Stopka. So since there's three of them, the other two might see you while you're attacking one, so I recommend waiting to see if they split up a little bit. Because you're guaranteed to drop if you kill six. And if you kill any after that, they have like a 40% chance to drop. But if you kill... Oh god, they're together. This is really bad. If you kill all six, it's a guaranteed drop. And then if you kill six again, so 12 is another guaranteed drop. Okay, so now this... Oh, that one saw me. Stop. I might have already been too late. Yep, so if you see these appearing on you, it means they've seen you, and they will continue to attack and infinitely spawn until you leave the area. So you need to get the fuck out of Dodge, because this is serious. They will destroy you. But yeah, that was kind of a bad one. Sometimes it's better when they like jump up on the sides and stuff like that. But yeah, this kind of takes me where I wanted to go, I guess, anyway. So we want to go turn in some more of these. I think we hit over 30. Probably, if not exactly 30. So, I don't know what this is. Fire Agaji. Oh, another one. So I must have over 40. That's crazy. That doesn't seem right. I don't like that I can't get my menu here. Anyway, if you go back to the second district, it'll spawn the enemies like normal. So, like I said, the best way to make those sniper... I think they're called sniper wilds. The best way to make them spawn again is to just go back, save, and just reload the file. Let me look at my journal real quick. Dalmatians, I have 33. So I guess they just gave me two for getting to 30. I can find it here. Heartless. Sniper Wild. So, right here. I've defeated 12 in total. That's good. You know, now that I think about it, I might have seen them in a different part, because I definitely have not defeated 12. But yeah, that's why the Pinocchio one comes in kind of handy, because it's got the increased attack. So green ones right here, they have a chance of dropping bright shards. Be sure to try and take them out. They're much easier now than they are later in the game. I think you can find... This area is pretty good, or Traverse Town in general is pretty good, because you'll find all four colors. Just going to run right around them. The best place, though, is the back alley. So if you go through the hotel, or if you go through the first area, the back alley has the best assortment of them, because I think it's only those four types of enemies. I'll show it after, because you can... I don't think you can get there from Merlin's house. But these ones are okay. It's just this, if you need to get spirit shards, this is where you can find soldiers, which are easier to kill in the large bodies, so I recommend this. I think these things drop spirit gems too, so worth killing them. You get a bunch of red guys. That's good. Okay, well, I accidentally used stop instead of blizzard. That's the thing, I don't like only having four commands. It bothers me a little bit. I don't know why I can't also use a circle command, but whatever. I'm more or less done. Just gonna go to Merlin's. So we should have two Winnie the Pooh minigames. Just before I forget, I want to make sure. There we go. So I'm going to do the two Winnie the Pooh pages, and then I'm going to do the Phil Cup, and then if I'm strong enough, I'll try the Pegasus Cup, but Knowing how the Phil Cup treated me, who knows? I should destroy the Phil Cup. Because I'm much, much higher leveled. But we'll see. Alright, so actually, before we do that, don't forget to talk to the Fairy Godmother, because we got Water Gleam, which means we unlocked a new summon. Talk. Oh, another summon gem. Let's help this one. Here we go. Bippity boppity boo. And we learned Dumbo from the hit movie Dumbo. One of my favorites. I like using Dumbo. Just because, well, you'll see. I don't think I can talk. So, don't practice magic. You want to talk to Merlin a couple times during the game, because he'll give you different keyblades and items based on how many spells you've unlocked. So if you unlock the 7 basic spells, which we're gonna, after we do the Phil Cup, we'll unlock the last spell. Then he'll give you a special keyblade. So I want to try that. And I think he gives different things to Donald, but I think it might be for having upgraded spells. So like Fire Aga, Blizzaga, all of those. And I think he gives you something when you unlock all the summons, but I'm not 100% sure. So I think the first area we want to go to is here. And then we want to go here, I think. That sounds right. Alright, so this is, you unlock this one for the first page. You want to do these because you unlock more spells, and after the second one, we'll actually unlock the fourth summon, which can be good for some specific things.
Hello? Is anyone there? What am I to do? I'm all alone. Pooh? Pooh? Where are you? It's me, Piglet.
Forgot about this part. I don't remember what I have to do here. Do I have to sneak up on? I have no memory of how I'm supposed to do this. Do I let him come out on his own? I don't remember how this works. I have no memory of how to do this. I don't know if I have to like leave the area or make it look like I'm about to leave. Does not look like it's letting me leave. Damn. I don't know what I'm supposed to do here. Just sneak up on him? I don't hit him, do I? It doesn't seem right. I don't remember this. Also, I don't remember this little pond. What the fuck is this? Where am I? I don't remember having problems here. Oh, okay. You gotta sneak up from that side. Got it.
Oh, I was just... never mind. I'm sorry.
Don't be scared. You're looking for Pooh, right?
You know Pooh. Oh, you see, I have something for him. I have to take it to Pooh right away. Oh, Pooh!
Oh, I believe I smell a delicious something. A something like honey.
Pooh!
Hello, Piglet. How have you been?
Oh, I'm so glad to see you. I thought you'd gone away. I brought what you asked for.
Thank you, Piglet. Now I can finally have some honey.
Really? But how?
I shall hold on to the balloon and fly like a bee up the honey tree, see?
But if you take their honey, won't the bees be angry?
Oh!
That's not how this works. That's not how any of this works. Dr. Him, when you start the first minigame. Now, one thing I want to mention, thanks, Al, is that the abilities like High Jump, they carry over into this world. They're one of the few things that do. So some of these become much easier if you have different abilities. So like for instance, the big thing you're going to do here is defend him from bees, and you're going to have to jump on each branch, and that is much easier with High Jump. Now Pooh can get honey by floating up to this tree with a balloon. The honey inside of the tree hollows is inside the tree hollows, not the beehives you see here. There's quite a lot of honey in these holes. If Pooh gets too close, the bees will come out to protect their honey. If they get to Pooh, they'll pop his balloon, lock onto the bees, and swap them away. The more time Pooh has at each hollow, the more honey he can eat up. There's more honey higher up, too. If jumping from branch to branch proves difficult, try the Rush Command. Rush can help you catch up to Pooh quickly, but it isn't fully reliable. Good luck. Yeah, Rush is a piece of shit. Just try not to fall off. That's the best advice I can give to you. Alright, so I do not enjoy this. The camera hates... The camera's not fun. But I recommend doing that because if you lock on, it's easier just to jump to the next branch. Also wait until they're closer to Pooh, because I think if as long as one is spawned, then another one can't spawn. That might not be true. I might have just made that up. But you have a time limit. Oh shit, I already fucked up. So they try to tell you to use Rush, which is just a triangle. Alright, fuck, did they let me retry? I'd rather not do this over. I'd rather do it perfectly the first time. Well, it's early, so we have time. Oh, god damn. That's why I don't like the controls in this tree. But yeah, basically, there's high scores and stuff like that. The easiest way to do it is just not fuck up. I also believe you can hit the... I thought you could hit him with magic, but I guess not. Let's hit that, because I'll land back on my branch, or I should. Best advice I can give is don't miss. If you miss, you're in trouble. And Rush, if you have time, don't bother with it. Oh, shit. Let's see. Okay, there we go. Oh, my God. Oh, man. I'm not gonna get him. This sucks. I don't like this. I'm not a fan. Fuck you guys. Terrible bees, I hate you. And I can't even lock on for some reason. I'm locking on to Piglet. Camera's not working. I'm not a fan of this minigame. At all. Oh my god, do I really have to lock on to them? But again, High Jump can help, because you can reach them faster. It's not an easy minigame. It's not fun either. I forget what the goal is. I think you have to get like 100 for the high score. That sounds right. I don't remember. But just like they said, the higher the holes, the more honey you can get, so focus on getting him up pretty quickly. This is another reason you want to let him get as close as possible, because then you won't get jumped too far away. That can go pretty fast. I don't want to be here. This is how I missed the last one. Okay, wait till he gets close. Oh man, that was... Whew, that was clutch. So this should be a good spot because that's the highest hive is right there. So if you hit it, you'll just get bumped right back here. Once you get here, you're pretty much clear. It's the fact that it automatically bumps you to the highest branch that'll kind of fuck you over a little bit. Well, it looks like I'm going to get 100. I don't know if it's 100 you need to pass the minigame or if it's 100... to get the high score, but it's one of those. If you get this cutscene, it means you cleared it.
is rather funny. What I will do for honey.
So just by clearing that, you should get a reward. Torn page turned into a new item, Nature Spark. Oh, so, okay, so you unlocked the fourth summon on the first one. The next one is actually here. I was mistaken. This one's kind of, okay, I don't hate this one. I don't think it's as bad as Rush, but or as the last one, but not my favorite. Nope, this is not where we have to go. I misled you. I lied to you. The second page should have turned into something. I don't think I have to exit. Plus, there's only three empty spots, which means... Oh, it's over here. Okay, there we go. I knew the location of the next one. That's why I was confused. I was like, I know where I'm supposed to go. I just don't know what it looks like on the map. Before we do too much, I recommend destroying or pulling out all of these. It is very long, it's very tedious, but they're free items. I don't know if they respawn every time you do it, but you can definitely get items this way, unless I'm a goddamn liar. I think you pull these out and you pull the cabbages out. My cabbages! There's like high potions and stuff. It's chump change, but it's free items nonetheless. Unless I'm a big fat liar and there's nothing here. Right now, I am Paul Giamatti. I'm all blue and I have an orange beard. This is me. It's happening right now. Okay, so pumpkins. Got nothing. Cabbages? Maybe? Perhaps? Did I make this up? Are there no items here? Why am I doing this? There's gotta be a reason. Why are none of these vegetables falling down? I'm asking the real questions here. Maybe there's a chance to get items for each one. I know I've gotten items here. Unless I imagined it. More than anything, now it's just OCD. Now I have to pull out all of them so that the fields can be even. I think there's definitely a couple items in here that aren't associated with minigames, though. I just don't remember where they are. I think there's some inside the house, there's some on the outside, maybe. It's been a while. I don't think I've played this in like a year and a half. Ah, great. So worth it. Can't pull these out. Okay, so I guess it's a random chance to find them. I don't think I can go in here right away. Nobody's home and I'm out of honey. Interesting. Open up his mailbox and nothing. And here's a cutscene. Is it voiced? Yes? No? Perhaps? Look, Rabbit's house came back, but it looks like Rabbit isn't home. Pooh's been calling, but the house says no one's there. I guess there are no items over here. Maybe I'm thinking of a different one. Nobody's home. That's right, nobody. Okay, so what happens when I go out on this side? Oh, look at me. I'm a trickster. Who is this person named Nobody? Nobody, have you seen Rabbit? Oh, God, the puns. No rabbits here. There's no one here. Pooh needs to be a dad. He's got, like, high-quality dad joke game. Hello, Rabbit. I like Rabbit's hat and scarf. Rabbit's supposed to be a girl, isn't she? Why, Pooh, what a pleasant surprise. Nice to see you, Piglet. And... Hello, I'm a stranger who's barged into your house. Is this a new friend? Pooh, I'm sorry, but... I'm all out of honey at the moment. I don't know why the fuck they had this in the cartoon. Why the fuck did Rabbit keep honey? He's a rabbit. They don't eat honey. So if you can't figure it out on your own, if you go up here, there is a pot of honey. Honey, how'd that get up there? I don't remember if they make you hit it down. Would you like some poo? Don't feel like you have to, of course. Oh, thank you. I was just like a small smack girl. I'm quite hungry. And as these pictures demonstrate... you don't need a whole lot, are you? Once you start, there's no stopping you, is there? And he pretty much just munches the whole thing. So glad to have found old Rabbit and Honey. Talk to Rabbit again. A lot of honey again. Or is he? I can't seem to grab that one. Do I have to leave? I think if you leave... Okay, I remember how this works. You start to leave, and it's help, please help. Piglet comes and trips because he's a dickhead. You look inside. Ah, yes, Pooh is stuck because he's eaten too much. What to do? All this because he can't, saying he can't stop liking honey so much. Pooh doesn't slim down. My house will stay plugged up forever. Only there was something we can do. Can I hit him? Oh, help and bother. I'm stuck again. I came through this hole, so it must have shrunk. Pooh is very American. Not because he's fat, just like the stubbornness. Or just like, clearly this hole is shrunk. I came in just fine. Talk to him. Oh, holy honey, if I'm stuck here. That's definitely the way to think. It's lunchtime, perhaps you can bring me a honey jar. No honey till you're unstuck. If Pooh doesn't slim down, my house will stay plugged up forever. If only there was something we can do. I can't skip this. Not that I would have, but just wanted to know I had the option. Wait, I know a bit of carrot top juice. I have a carrot patch on the other side of the stream. Carrot top juice is just a ticket to slimming down a Pooh. Ha! Huh, that's funny. Slimming down a Pooh. Oh no. Oh yes. It's the one. The only.
Hey there! Name's Tigger! T-I-double-G-R. That spells Tigger! Well now, I don't think I've ever seen you before.
Hello, Tigger. You've just bounced my new friend, Sora.
Hey, Pooh! Say, you're looking mighty uncomfy today. Is that some new exercise? Why, bouncing around is a lot more fun!
Why do you bounce around so much, Tigger?
Why? Because bouncing's what Tiggers do best! Speaking of which, my bouncing spot has gone and disappeared! So for now, this will be my new bouncing ground!
I'm trying to figure out who Tigger's voice actor is. All I know is the same dude who voices Winnie the Pooh also voices Pete. Oh, he does both. Okay, so he does Winnie the Pooh and Tigger. That makes sense. Okay. Tigger's bouncing will ruin my vegetables. If we don't give Pooh some carrot top juice, if we suck forever. Please help me keep Tigger away from my carrots. I like how in the subtitles he spells carrot correctly, but not on his patch. It's quite a fix, but I have just the solution. Pay attention now. Oh, God. Sorry, I'll have to protect this carrot patch. Tigger bounces on a carrot twice, it'll be buried. So why are you already burying them? Once. And then twice. And we don't have shovels in the 100 Acre Woods, so once it's buried, it's fucked. There's no way. Just like that. Protect the carrots from Tigger's bounces and you'll receive points. How you ask? It's elementary. Simply get to the carrots before Tigger lands on them. There are 15 carrots here. Your score depends on how many you save and how many times you block Tigger. Oh, and one more thing. What are you going to tell me? What's going on here? The rush command is the key to a high score. Select rush when while near a carrot that isn't buried yet. You'll dash the target area before Tigger lands. Well, good luck. I don't remember how to do this. I think I have to do it. I usually have to do it once or twice. Extra times, I mean. Luckily, it's a quick mini game. Beat Tigger to the carrots before he bounces them into the ground. Okay. Did not beat it that time. Rush. Boom. So it's all about timing, really. Either A, you can wait and see where he's going to land, or not. Or you can hit the rush command right before he lands. But again, rush is not an exact science. I don't know how many times you have to block them. You can usually tell where he's going to go based on the direction. And also... Shit. Did not give me the option there. Rush sucks. I hate it. I guess just wait and press rush and hope for the best. Some of them don't work. It looks like he also will jump on places even though carrots are already buried. Really? Rush, give me something here. I don't know how many times you have to block him or how many carrots you have to save, but I don't think it's a crazy hard amount. Plus, it's only 60 seconds. Time's blocked, 10, carrots saved 11. 110, so it's, I'm assuming it's both those numbers times each other.
Hey, you kept up pretty good there, Sora. Especially for a non-Tigger. Let's have another go.
Thank you so much. I'd better make that carrot top juice. I'll get the carrots. Please wait inside the house. So, my best recommendation for that one is the more times you block them, the better. Because A, each block counts as one of the multiples, but A, or, but because you also, every block defends the carrots. So, the more carrots you save, the more blocks, the higher the score. When I say please wait inside the house, this one takes surprisingly long for how quick that minigame was. This is like the 100 Acre Wood equivalent of Metal Gear Solid 4. Very little gameplay, lots of cutscene. Oh, what a day I gave Pooh the carrot top juice. All we have to do now is push him out. It's just a little push to do it. Why do I have a feeling a little push isn't gonna happen? Talk. Cutscene. First my vegetable patch, and now this. So you couldn't tell.
It's ever so dark in here.
This was...
It isn't so bad, I suppose. There is plenty of honey.
That was Rabbit's hidden stash of honey. Again, Rabbit's a terrible friend. Oh, I don't have any. Sorry, buddy. I'm, like, trying to hide, like, booze or something. Torn page turned into a new item. Mithril shard. Not worth the effort I just put in. But we are done here. So I just go back, take the Meadow Gleam over to, why am I forgetting her name? Over to the Fairy Godmother. Get that up, that will make our fourth summon. You can unlock that much earlier than I did it. So you can undo that as soon as you finish Agrabah, which I believe is the first possible Torn Page. Talk to her again, can't skip this. There are two summons left. One of them you get for... Well, both... Neither of them are chests. One of them you unlock right away, just like you unlock Genie. And the other one is an item that you beat for, get for beating a boss. Both of them are useful for their own ways. You know, now that I think... I don't think there's any summons that I think are completely useless. I was going to come back here. Right, after I beat the Folk up. The only ones that are kind of on the fence about are Genie and Simba pretty much do the same thing, which is they're both better at multiple attacks at once than they are for like a single target. Maybe Genie is pretty good. Maybe that just wasn't a good fight for him. I wish I could show him off more, but I don't think the Colosseum is really the place for him. Because I don't think you can have summons, if I remember. Alright, so we're about to destroy the Fill Cup, and then might have some luck in the Pegasus Cup, but who's to say? First things first, though, if you go over here, we have our Trinity, and this should unlock a Mithril. Probably some other drops, if I had to guess. Mithril. It's really weird. I don't know why I needed green for that. So if you look at this, you can actually get a sneak peek of who we're going to fight. So the bosses of the Pegasus Cup are Leon and Yuffie, which we have not fought yet, so that'll be interesting. Leon fights about how you'd expect him to fight. Yuffie has a couple tricks up her sleeve, too. Fill Cup, enter together. I think I'll do the timed one and the solo one at another time. I could probably do them, but it's just... It's only so much easier when you're more powered up. Okay, so this should not be hard at all. It's not. Donald can solo these guys. That's how easy they are. I don't know if these become harder. I don't know if these cups become harder once all of the enemies become increased across the world. I don't know if that affects them. If it does, then I recommend doing these first three tournaments sooner than later, but... That's about it. I recommend doing a lot of things before the enemy powers up. I don't remember exactly when that happens, though. I know it's before a certain world, but that's about it. I also don't remember if they get powered up three times or just once. I think it's only once in Kingdom Hearts 1. In 2, the enemies get powered up every so often, so it's less of an exact thing. Deep freeze. Okay. Those still hit her a lot, but I also have Sonic Blade, so I can just spam that. I think I have a decent amount of items, because you can still use items in these. But I'm only going to use those in like an emergency. I thought about doing this off screen and then just like starting a part with me at like round 10 or like the final round, but since we're here, I might as well. It seems like kind of a waste of time, but it's also interesting to point out the disparity and like how much stronger I am than I was before. Because just wiping the floor with these guys. I definitely should have used Blizzard right at the start of this. I forgot that. Still someone left. Donald, come on. You're better than this, Donald. Donald, please. Thank you. Yeah, this will probably be the end of it. I'll try the Pegasus Cup. I'm not expecting much. But that'll be the end of this part. I know we didn't really do anything, but the side quest stuff is... Well, no, because 100 Acre Wood counts, because I definitely would have included that even if... because I don't count that as a side quest. I count that as like a full world. That was awesome. I sidestepped him, and I was not attempting to. So yeah, we did a couple of things. I wanted to wrap it up more than anything. And then the next part, we'll go to the next world. And it'll be tons of fun and stuff. I should mention, I'm doing all of this in the same day. Kind of like how I've been filming Okami. Since I'm doing so many more videos a week, it feels like it'd be easier if I did more at a time. So that's what I'm attempting to do. Nice. That's good. I like it. I think a thumbnail for this one will probably be Tigger, just because it's easier. It'll draw the attention. Some people will skip this part then, because not everyone likes 100 Acre Wood. I don't mind it. It's not, you know, it's not a traditional world, but it, we cannot leave this dude around. He will heal them. It's not a traditional world, and some people don't like it just because, you know, Winnie the Pooh, I mean, all of these are like Disney games, like, come on. They're all for kids, so I don't feel anything about it. They're mini games, they break the monotony, so it's not that bad. Doing them for the journal sucks, though, because getting specific scores is never easy. I actually want to look at that after this, because that can be a huge pain in the ass. It's way worse than 2, but in this one it can be bad, too. What level are we on? I think we've got 2 or 3 more after this. I use Sonic Blade. I hate these feet. I'll wreck them. Alright. Now we've got gloves. Gauntlets, I mean. Whatever you want to call them. Donald, you really die? Come on, this is the Phil Cup. We can easily beat this. Alright. No MP. Donald's dead. It's a good sign. I still have an elixir, or 2 elixirs and a mega elixir, so I'm not too worried. I should save them, though. There's a specific enemy that I recommend saving them for. It's one of the secret enemies they added in Final Mix. It's not a boss, but it's much easier to fight if you have an elixir. It works the same way that zombies do in all the other Final Fantasy games, where if you hit them with a healing item, it does massive damage. Oh man, am I gonna die here? I might. I should use... Nope, I should... Not you. I just said not to use one. I'm gonna use it right now. I hate this. Oh man, that thing is. I have guard. This should not be hard anymore. This should be easy to fight, and it's not. It is easy. Damn it. All right. Well, that's the Phil Cup. Donald, good job. Why is he the victory pose? He did nothing. It's like the guy who does the most celebrating at the end of a fucking trial in Final Fantasy XIV when they died 10 seconds in.
We're the champs!
Yay, you don't even have a trophy. Got nothing to celebrate. You get a little card that says, oh, you won, you're the best. Attain the power of the stars, earn the magic spell Gravity, so we now have all 7 spells. So that's good. I never thought you'd do it. Not bad. Failure, just as stubborn as ever. Don't pretend you're not happy for them. Ahem, now, kid, you still got a long way to go. Next round's starting soon. Next time it'll be the real thing. I am worried what he's saying is true. So actually, you see over here, Phil Cup Championship Trophy. And then you know the rules, right? Pegasus Cup. Okay, I should share this first. Now that we've beaten Phil Cup, you can then do it alone, and then after that, you can do it in the time trial. So we'll do Pegasus Cup. I've warned against people, like, you know, you should do things before the enemies all get stronger, but at the same time, if you grind enough at the end of the game, you can easily defeat them even after they all power up, which you might have to for some of the extra bosses and stuff like that. So as you can see, they waste no time. All of these enemies only spawn after, or they've only, how do I put this? All of these are enemies that are new since the Phil Cup, meaning, like, these are all from worlds that we did after the Phil Cup was unlocked. I know the Flyers spawn in Traverse Town, the Ghosts, Monstro, Bandits in Agrabah. Barrel Spider, Shadows. Okay, so the Barrel Spider I recommend here more than any time. I recommend taking care of them with fire, because if they run into you, it's a lot more high stakes than, say, when you're out in the field, because you can heal so much less. So that's definitely the way I recommend taking care of them, because you don't want them to deal their damage this early on, because it'll be a lot harder to come back from. I forget what I earned for the Pegasus Cup. I think it might be equipment. One Barrel Spider. Let's take care of it as soon as we can. Bam. Nothing. Watch out for these large bodies. They're stronger than normal. They still give the same amount of XP, which is not great. Wow, Donald really took this guy to the cleaners. And then he immediately took him there. It's okay, buddy. You did your best. So I have the best items I think I can. Actually, I didn't check the store again. They might have added more equipment after I beat Monstro. But I'm alright with it. So, this one's easy. They all have low HP, so you don't have to focus the green guys first. It just, you know, it helps. Stop moving. I don't have sliding dash. Or sliding dash isn't effective. So they move in circles. What's left? I hate the way these guys move. Alright. Easy, easy. You know, I might be able to win the Pegasus Cup. I think Agrabah leveled me up a lot. Because there's so many bosses and just a lot of enemies. This isn't so tough. I guess just have at it. I could have blocked that. I tried. That's why I dodge rolled forward, because I was trying to block. I think it might be worth it to try and use Sonic Blade here, because there's just so many enemies. Although sometimes that can happen, where you'll miss because they teleport. So it might, for these, it's sometimes better to lock on first. Yes! I'm so proud of that. Do it. Time it. Nope. Oh, damn it, okay. Again, I'm in trouble. I don't have any MP. Bam! That is very satisfying. I recommend everyone do that, just for the feeling it gives after. I need to land some hits so I can charge my MP back up. Nobody has any MP. I think I have a Mega Ether. This might be the best time to use it, actually. Oh, cool. Goofy healed everyone. Black Fungus. We fought them in Agrabah. Same thing. Try and get them separated, because they'll be a lot harder if they're not. They will decimate your partners. That is just unavoidable. Let them walk away from each other and then try and fight the ones who are separate from each other. Did they kill one? Holy crap. Was not expecting that. I guess it's the invincibility that really gets them. Yeah, done. Not hard at all. Okay. So they're the fourth seed, which means I have three more battles to go. The last one's probably going to be tough. Alright, same thing. Barrel Spiders, take care of them as soon as possible. I was using the wrong button. Shit. Well, that could have gone better, could have gone worse. Boom. What I hate about these guys, they don't give any XP. They're not hard, but they hit kind of hard, but they don't have that much HP. Keep holding R2, or L2 instead of L1 for the customize button, and then they yell at me. I don't know what that button actually does. So these guys and then the boss, they're going to spit at me like almost immediately. Don't do it. Okay. I need health. I don't know what to do here. They're all just using their fire breath. Looks like they're taking care of the large bodies. If I just walk around, maybe I'll get lucky. Nope. There we go. Okay. I'll go after this one. Oh, no. Why did he attack me? That one just missed. Okay, so that's one down. And that should stop him in their tracks a bit. Oh, man. I'm not doing well. I should probably try and heal one of them. Oh, man. This is rough when there's so many, like, together. That's three down. I need two more. Goofy is the real MVP on these ones. Okay, Goof, let's try and take him out. One more. This one has, like, full health, though. Although, when there's just one, it's not as hard. Who was he aiming at? I couldn't have blocked that if I tried. Alright. Not in a great position. So, for this one, you fight two at once. I recommend taking Yuffie out first, because I think she can heal. Plus, obviously, Leon hits much harder, because he's the main character. So make sure to switch targets. Be sure to watch out for Leon, because he'll come and hit you hard. Yuffie can also use ranged attacks. Okay, let's hope for the best here. So you can hit hers back at her, or block them, I assume. Is that her Lunafrake? I've never seen that attack. I don't know if that's one she uses in the game. Oh god, that stupid shuriken. Oh, I'm gonna die from this. This is how I die. Oh, I can't see anything. It stuns her if you hit him too. Sonic Blade. I don't have enough MP for this, but I'll try it anyway. And then final hit. There we go. Now it's just Leon, whose attacks are a little bit more predictable, but I don't know if I want to waste a Mega Elixir here. He likes to stay on the ground, so Sonic might be good for him. I did some earlier. Okay, let's get some hits in. You can parry his attack sometimes too, which means it might be better to use three wishes on him, because harder to block. Oh god, this one sucks. Jump. I want to wait for his thing to go down. Oh god, the range on that! Wow, he hit Donald right out of the air. I don't know what he does with this. I know it wears off. Just stay away from him. That's my advice here. God damn. The way he says I don't stand a chance, and I believe him. I might have to just start hitting him. I guess that would be an opening. I don't want him to do that swipe at me, though. Like that. But when he does that, huge opening. Oh, my range is bad. Okay, there we go. I think they use different attacks based on who's the last one standing. But I still think Leon's more predictable. So, he's the one I like going for. Hit. No. Oh, god. That should have hit me. Kinda. This is hard. Alright, there's always Sonic Blade. You hit him enough to recharge, I think, anyway. Finish. Oh, man, no. Okay, that's it. I don't care. I'm too close. I just want to do it. By the way, Yuffie will never get up, so that's not something you have to worry about. Bam. Just do another one. I guess Sonic Blade is strong enough where it stuns him. I don't recommend wasting all of those items just to beat this, but it's certainly satisfying. And isn't that the most important thing? This fight is not nearly as hard on Proud. It's all about how much damage you're taking, which you get a lot more on Proud. So, you know, don't take that much damage. Why am I not holding a trophy up? I get that we're the champs, but I like it better when I hold the trophy instead of my busted up Keyblade. Or broken. It just looks busted up, but I know it's not. Oh, I forgot I learned Strike Raid. Okay. Strike Raid is like Sonic Blade. It looks like Phil's trained another great hero. Strength, the most important part of a hero. Well, what you really need is a strong heart. What makes a strong heart? If you have to ask, you're not a hero yet. Stop talking in riddles. It's not a riddle. Be fair, it's not a riddle. You get your second trophy. Oh no, this one is a little plaque. I always thought the plaque was for the Phil Cup. I don't know why. I thought that was like the least impressive one. So Strike Raid works the way Sonic Blade does. You can equip both of them at once, but then the triangle attack will change occasionally. I prefer Sonic Blade, and Strike Raid is good because you can get it from a long, from a decent bit away, which can be better for some combos. So I recommend equipping them both, but at the same time, they do start to interfere with each other. I think a good replacement for... I think my magic is as good as Donald's now. No way, not in a million years. Why don't you go see Merlin work on your magic? They say that, and it's kind of a hint. Once you unlock all seven magic, Merlin will give you a new Keyblade. I don't remember if it's the strongest you can have at this point. It might be. It's Spellbinder, and it obviously increases your magic. What I'm trying to remember is if it's also stronger than Wishmaker, is that what it's called? And Three Wishes. Not doing too bad though. All right. It's gonna bother me. Wishing Star. I knew it was wishing something. Talk to him. You're making excellent progress. Here's something for your efforts. Spellbinder. Keep it up. Not gonna practice much. Oh, you can go to the cavern. You just gotta talk to him. Okay. Let's see where this stands. Spellbinder has lower attack, but the magic and summoning power is much higher. I don't think I use enough magic to warrant this. Although it would be good to have that much MP for like techniques and stuff like that, but the lower in strength, I'm not a huge fan of. I'd rather have strength. And plus, Wishing Star has more, it has a better ability. For, like, I guess that one increases magic power, but I like the idea of, you know what? I think I might have to try to drive to Monstro. I go the way Monstro goes, but if I'm lucky, he won't show up. I think it happens like 50% of the time, where you go towards Monstro and he just sometimes just won't appear. Sometimes it can happen, sometimes it won't. I think the best chance is to just go, though. Alright, let's take a normal drive here. Otherwise, I could always go the long way around, but I'd rather not if I didn't have to. I forgot the controls again. I get it every time I do this. Where did those blasts come from? Also, I definitely have the parts to make a better ship, so I probably should have, but I didn't. It's the obstacles that keep hitting me. I need the special. It's the whole reason I'm breaking these meteors. There we go. But that's gonna be it on this part. I think I'm just gonna get to this new area, get the intro cutscene, and then I'll save and we'll pick up next time. Just because it seems like a decent point to leave off. Like, I don't want to just, like... I'd rather get this out of the way now, because gummy ships are not my favorite parts, so I'd rather just do this all now and then start fresh. So as you can see, the MP bar, which is the power bar when you're in a gummy ship, goes down the more lasers you fire, but you can easily get repair items. Just be careful, if you spam it too much, you won't be able to use it when you need it sometimes, so just be aware of it, but that's all. It's not going to be a big problem. Let me see. So this is the point where monster has a chance to spawn, or you'll move on to the next section. It's changing. Usually they... Oh no, we haven't even got to that part yet. Usually they'll say something like, I guess monster is not here. So it's usually easy enough to figure out. I think I might be wrong, but I think the donut strategy might only work if you have the max amount of space to build a ship. So I might not even have like a good ship here. I might have just made this for no reason. I was literally curling my toes as I was going through those rings because I was like, am I gonna do it? So many. It's like the apocalypse. Oh god, so many. Okay, there we go. Carlos sent me a text. He finished Metal Gear. Means I'm probably gonna have a conversation with him. Yes, okay. Monstro's gone, let's go before he comes back. So that's, if sometimes you'll get Monstro, sometimes you won't. If you do, go back to your ship from the Monstro's save point, in Geppetto's old ship. Because you can still get him. Like, it's not like you're sealed off from going back in. Obviously, I went back to get that torn page. Yeah, so if you come in, if you, like, drive the normal way, he has a chance to appear. It can be a pain in the ass because it can ruin some of the gummy missions, but if he appears, just go back to the world and then start over. And he shouldn't appear twice in a row, I don't think. So don't worry too much about it. It can be annoying, but you know, if you know how it works, it's not that bad. It's not literally like a random chance that he appears each time. It's like he'll appear, and if he appears again, then just try again. Now this level is actually kind of long, so it might take two parts. I'm not sure. It's about as long as Agrabah is. Disembark. Okay, guys, prepare for landing. I like how long it takes to move this conversation along. Land where? In the sea? We'll drown. Not with my magic, we won't. Just leave it to me. Not with my magic, we won't. Okay, that's a comma, not a period.
Sebastian?
Ariel, wait! Slow down! Don't leave me behind!
No, relax, Sebastian. They don't look like one of them. Right, Flounder?
I don't know. There's something weird about them.
What do you mean?
They do seem a little different. Where are you from?
We're from kind of far away. And we're not really used to these waters.
Oh, I see. In that case, Sebastian can show you how we swim around here.
Ariel! King Triton will not like this!
Oh, don't worry.
Easy for you to say, okay, it's time to learn how to swim properly. I'm not going to do a Jamaican accent. I will offend far too many people. Back to swimming with Flounder, the Triton Dragon. Nope. Fight this. You can do it. All right, begin. So this is just a basic tutorial. Circle goes up, square goes down, X to hit things, triangle same as always, swim to flounder. They're gonna give me this whole fucking explanation, even though I clearly know how to swim already. I'm gonna find him again, so turn back around, go down. Hey, buddy. This time swim up. You can target him, makes it easier to swim. I think if you target him, you'll automatically go to his level. Is that him right there? Yeah, you'll automatically swim that way, so swim this way again. I don't even know where he is. I just know I'm locked on. So that means he's probably up. Yep. There he is. Now I gotta go all the way back down. I get it. Flounder, I appreciate it, but I mean, I've got this. I've swam before.
Good job! Now let's move on to safe defense!
Sebastian!
Eh?
Alright, so remember how when I was talking about synthesis, I believe these guys drop cross gems. So this is a quick battle tutorial. It's not hard. It's more or less even. I think it's easier sometimes. You just gotta kind of swim in the general vicinity and you'll automatically walk towards them. I think you'll get a couple waves here. I don't think it's just them. Or it is just them. Alright, that was way too easy. I'm assuming we have to talk to Ariel again. Wow, nice job. Wow, nice job. Let's hit this. Or not. I'm gonna make it like I'm gonna leave. If you need to find the palace, follow those. I don't know why they give you those as opposed to every other area. Hey, you can't just leave us. What the fuck do you want me to do? Open? Says me? Okay. Examine. Hitting it might open it. So that's also a tutorial. There's no chests in Atlantica. It's all clams like that, and you have to hit them to open them. Those creatures chase us here. I know those monsters might be heading for the palace too. We'd better head back right away. But what if we run into more on our way? Sorry, we need your help. Please come to the palace with us. Strident markers on the walls point the way here. We won't get lost as long as we follow them. All right, let's go. Getting to the palace, super fucking easy. Getting anywhere else you need to go, not easy at all. All right, so that's that. I made this part way longer than I wanted it to be, but that's fine. I mean, that's not that bad. Yeah, we're good. So thank you for watching, and tune in for the next one.